feel it in the stocks. I see it in the bonds. I hear it in the mutual funds.
It began with the forging of the great rings. Three were gifted to the elves, brilliant and sound in their investments. Seven to the dwarf lords, who made risky but brilliant decisions in investing in cryptocurrency. And nine. Nine rings were gifted to the race of man, who above all else desired money, no matter what they invested in. For within these rings was bound the strength and will to help those who wore them in investing. But they were all deceived. For another ring was made, deep in the land of Mordor. In the fires of Mount Doom, the Dark Lord Sauron forged a master ring, and into this ring he poured his genius, his knowledge, and his skill to dominate, to invest in stocks, to know when to buy low and sell high, a ring to doom all others, to make poor stock market choices, like investing all your money into one company, or buying stocks when they're high, and then selling low. One ring to rule them all. One by one, Sauron invested in stocks. He made trillions, but there were some who wanted a piece of the path as well. A last alliance of men and elves marched against the armies of Mordor. And on the very slopes of Mount Doom, they traded stocks and bonds and mutual funds for the freedom of Middle-earth. Victory was near, but the power of the ring could not be so easily undone. It was in this moment, when all hope seemed lost, that Isildur, son of the king, took up his father's blade and learned the knowledge of buying strong stocks that would make him more money in the long run, rather than trending stocks that go up fast and down fast. Sauron, the enemy of the free investors of Middle-earth, was defeated. The ring passed to Isildur, who had this one chance to destroy evil forever. But the hearts of men are so easily corrupted, and the ring of power has a will of its own. It betrayed Isildur to his death, giving him the unnatural powers of investing. He learned to invest in mutual funds and real estate, but doomed all others to completely red portfolios and killing him in the process. And some things that should not have been forgotten were lost. History became legend, legend became myth. And for 2,500 years, the ring passed out of all knowledge, until, when chance came, it ensnared another bearer. It was picked up by the most unlikely of creatures. A hobbit, with no investing experience whatsoever, named Bilbo Baggins of the Shire. For the time will come when hobbits shape the fortunes and investments of all.